very quiet. That's a nice colour. Got pretty marked up, isn't it? Well, obviously that is all.
It's all reproduced.
Yeah, everything that is there on the original. Is it the right colour? I think it is. I think it is. I'd like to say that it's a fantastic repro. I mean, it's a great guitar to play. That's the thing. Yeah. Well, I might have to turn it up, I'm afraid. You're not gonna like this. Time spent in New York in the 60s where I was traveling around with Cream, and I can't remember whether I was with Cream, it may have been. I played this on Guitar Gently Weeps, you know. See, George is capable, would have been capable of setting this up. I remember bringing it back from America and wanting to give it to him because I already had one, I think. I had another Les Paul. And I gave it to him, and I think when he asked me to do the session for Gently Weeps, it sounds right because he picked me up from where I was living in London and said, "We're going to go over the studio. Do you want to come along?" And I said, "Yeah." And he said, "Well, I want you to play on something." And I didn't have a guitar because I was just got in the car with him, you know. And so he gave me this to play. So he could have put a Marshall in there, knowing that he was going to ask me to come and play, you know, just to make it like, well, we got this and we got that, you know. My ideal setup for a long time then was a Gibson, a Les Paul through a Fender Twin, only because that sounded like the Marshall, because the original partnership was a Les Paul through a small Marshall, the Blues Breakers setup, and that was pretty hard to, I never got a Marshall again. They were all unique. And what I liked about discovering the twins was that, you know, they were pretty much made to a similar pattern. You know, you get a 50s tweed twin and it would sound just like the last one or the other one, you know, and consistent and great for Les Pauls, really thick, you know, Freddie King. He was the first guy I ever heard play in that kind of BB T-Bone Walker style, single line playing with bended, you know, bended notes. And you know, the first thing I heard was Hideaway. I had the single of Hideaway. Someone turned me on to that. And on the B side of Hideaway was a song called I Love the Woman, which has probably got the most iconic short single chorus blues solo you'll ever hear. And I heard that, luckily enough, when I was, you know, in my mid-teens, 16, 17, and that was it. And then I found that the album that he made, that song was on, and it was called Freddie King Sings the Blues. It's gone now, but I had on vinyl. He was playing, it was Les Paul, but it could have been a gold top. I thought that when I next saw a Les Paul in the shop in London, that was the same one, but it was a Les Paul, you know, it was a Sunburst.